Good morning everyone. Today is the unit 3 class 4 where we will be discussing about the cholesterol to bile acid synthesis. Yesterday in previous class I have discussed about the cholesterol synthesis. Now degradation of cholesterol will be discussing. So we know cholesterol is a light yellow crystalline powder. It has 27 carbon compound and the ring which is known as the cyclopentanoparhydrophenanthrene ring, and one hydroxyl group is present at the third position. There is a double bond in between 5 to 6 carbon and there is an 8 carbon side chain at the 17th carbon. See, this is the structure here. Whereas you can see there is a third position OH group is there. At 18 and 19th position there is a methyl group, and 5 to 6 position there is a double bond. Okay, and in the 17th position there is a carbon chain. Okay, now the cholesterol will be signified. In different cases, cholesterol is a very important constituent of our body, whereas normal level is 150 to 200 microgram per deciliter, milligram per deciliter. If the level is increased, there is risk of atherosclerosis. It is an important component of cell membrane, but if the concentration is increased, it will affect the fluid state of membrane. It is used to insulate the nerve fiber. Different bile acids are derived from cholesterol. They are used for different bile acid synthesis, which is used for lipid metabolism. Now importantly, steroid hormone, 21 carbon containing glucocorticoids, 19C androgen and 18C estrogens are there. They are produced from the cholesterol, and mostly important, vitamin D is synthesized from the cholesterol. Now degradation of cholesterol. Cholesterol is not completely degraded to carbon dioxide or water, but it is converted to bile acid, steroid hormone and vitamin D. Bile acid is an important compound present in the bile gland, helps in the digestion and absorption of lipids, and the synthesis takes place in the liver. The 7-hydroxylase enzyme is the regulating enzyme who will be helping for the synthesis of bile acid. So there are two types of bile acid, primary and secondary. Primary are the folic acid and the chinodeoxycarboxylic acid. And secondary bile acids are there. They are deoxycholic acid and lithocholic acid. See the pathway. The cholesterol is converted to 7-hydroxycholesterol, where 7-alpha-hydroxylase enzyme helps to synthesize. Then there are several steps. In this step, folic acid. So with the help of glycine, it is converted to glycocholic acid. With the taurine, it is converted to taurocholic acid. They are the important constituents of bile acid. Now, intestinal bacteria will be helping for the degradation. Next, in this step, the chinodeoxycholic acid is converted with taurine to glycine, taurine or glycine. They are also converted to tauro and glycochinodeoxycholic acid. And with the intestinal bacteria, they are converted to deoxycholic acid. And in the intestinal bacteria, here also lithocholic acid. They are the secondary bile acid. So you have to remember the total biosynthesis pathway. Next, these are the structure where folic acid and chinodeoxycholic acid is the precursor, where glycolate. Folate, because there is a COO minus, where a sodium will be there, it will be converted as a sodium glycocholate, and if there is a taurocholate, then a salt will be forming with the sulfate group, that is known as the taurocholate. See, the structure are present. Next, transformation of cholesterol with the steroid hormone. The steroid hormones are progesterone, estradiol, cortisol, testosterone, and most important, vitamin D. So different male hormone and different female hormone are different female hormone and different male hormone are produced by the steroid hormones. Now the disorders. First disorder is hypercholesterolemia. The serum cholesterol level is more than 200 mg per deciliter, then it is known as the hypercholesterolemia. And what are the causes? Diabetes mellitus, hypothyroidism, obstructive jaundice, nephrotic syndrome, these are the. And what will be the resulting? Atherosclerosis, that is the deposition of cholesterol esters into the internal walls of artery and blood vessels following coronary and cerebral arteries. See, this is the structure here, atherosclerosis, the vein and artery to the heart where the steroids are deposited. See, the steroids are deposited here As a result, the blood cannot properly circulate through this artery and vein. So there is a oxygen deficiency. As a result, spasm or pain there in our heart. So this is the blockage in right coronary artery, where this will be leading to the heart attack or cardiac arrest. See, this is a narrowed artery. There are some treatment, that is the rotational bud, balloon surgery, you have listened about it. There is a stent surgery. If they are placed, then the cholesterol are just kept as tight and blood flows are circulating properly. Next, treatment. You have to consume PUFA, that is the polyunsaturated fatty acid. That will decrease the cholesterol. Dietary fiber will be decreasing. Avoiding high carbohydrate fat, because they will be increasing the cholesterol. And drug like lovastatin and atorvastatin will also help you to decrease the cholesterol synthesis. Next, cholestyramine and cholestipitol. They will be decreasing the heart's problem. So first of all natural product you should take. No fat, no cholesterol, no carbs, no sodium, high rich and no chemical additives. And if we have spiced it up in our body, we will be following different problem. So thank you all. So you should study the chapter from where, what is cholesterol, what are the degradation, and bile acid synthesis pathway is the most important, different structures and different conformation of cholesterol, different transformation, different disorders. Thank you all for listening.